Hi there. My name is Jasmine. I love movies. I love talking about movies. So here's a YouTube channel all about that. The first movie I want to talk about is Elvis, the new Elvis Presley biopic by Baz Luhrmann. Amazing movie. Stay tuned to the end and you'll get a rating out of 5 stars that I give it. But before that, I just want to talk about it a little bit. Okay. Let's get into it. So, if I look over, that's because I have my little notes there. Just heads up. First thing I want to talk about is just Baz Luhrmann as a director, right? Amazing director. I'm a big fan personally. A few of his past works that you might have heard of, because they're pretty big: The Great Gatsby with Leonardo DiCaprio, Romeo and Juliet with Leonardo DiCaprio, and Moulin Rouge with Obi-Wan Kenobi. All movies that I really enjoy. Moulin Rouge a little less so. I think it has a bit more flaws than the other two, but all in all, so stylistic, so fun, love them. Baz Luhrmann specifically has such a distinct style in all of his movies that I think separates him from anybody in the industry right now. Everything he does, you just know that it is Baz Luhrmann doing that. I am such a fan of when directors have their own styles, and I feel like that's something I'm missing a lot in more recent movies. When I think of like Marvel movies now and action movies in general, they all have this very similar color grading, editing style, directing style, and Baz Luhrmann always comes out with something new and exciting, and I just really appreciate that from him. I think that with this editing style comes some flaws, I will say, or with this filming style comes some flaws, one being that more people might dislike it for that reason, that they might find it a little bit odd or whatnot. But I think that having this style just really gives him a voice and makes everything he does just a little bit more personal and special. And with a movie with somebody like Elvis as the front runner, you want a style that's going to complement the character itself and the story you're telling. And I think Baz Luhrmann's like almost absurd editing style and bright, vibrant color grading is just the perfect choice for a character like Elvis, right? It would make a lot of sense. His editing style, though, in this movie, 2 hour and 40 minute long movie, can be a lot at times, but I think it kept me in the movie a bit more than if it were edited in, say, Christopher Nolan's kind of more gray, blue, orange color grading style and simple editing style. This kept me in it and kept me interested the whole time, which I really appreciated. And I want to see more of that from directors, actually. I feel like I just lose a lot of style unless I'm seeing something more independent, perhaps like an A24 production house movie. You miss a lot of that style that you get from somebody like Baz Luhrmann, which I really appreciate. One thing that he always does in his movies that I love is his choice of music. So, in, say, The Great Gatsby, we get a Beyoncé song halfway through. Some people dislike this because they feel it takes them out of the setting or the tone that we're trying to set, but I think it just complements the story he's telling so much more. Great Gatsby, something with this man who's so lavish and rich that he throws these parties that are just so big. Wouldn't it make sense to give it the music that it deserves in that moment, to also modernize it, keep it interesting, and keep your audience engaged? I think it really helps in that way. In Elvis specifically, he has some really interesting choices because Elvis is a musician himself, obviously, the king of rock and roll, he's known as. You get more remixes and collabs that you would never expect. One of the best, in my opinion, comes in a montage where we're hearing the song "Edge of Reality," and it is a collab between Elvis and Tame Impala. Something I would never expect to see or to work, and yet it worked perfectly and complements what you're seeing on the screen so well. Speaking of that, my favorite scene actually comes when Elvis is in Graceland talking to his parents. He's a little bit frustrated, just needs some space, wants to go blow off some steam. So he gets into a purple Cadillac. He starts driving. He's kind of upset. He's switching through channels, hearing his own song. And he's like, oh, don't want to hear that right now. Ends up switching, and what comes on is a Denzel Curry rap song. Something I would never have expected, but oh my goodness, was it my favorite scene of the whole movie. We're seeing this intense rap song while Elvis is feeling these intense emotions, and he's driving kind of furiously, and this is edited in such a way that's complementing the song and Elvis's mood. So we're getting like some of these slow motion movements of him walking with this like swagger. Austin Butler's walk is everything to me, by the way. That's a side point, but oh my gosh, it is perfect. He's walking with this swagger, with this anger, while the song's playing in the background. We're getting slow motion shots. People are rushing up to him on Beale Street because they just love what he's doing. Goodness gracious, great scene. You have to see it in theaters if you haven't already. That is definitely one of the most noticeable for me. I've also heard it's some people's least favorite scene, ironically, for the same reasons that it's my favorite. But I think it just stands out in such a beautiful way and just perfectly sets the tone that Baz is trying to get across. So I'm a big fan of that scene personally. I also want to get into, because this scene touches on it a little bit, Baz's choice to not hold Elvis too accountable for his theft of black music. It's a known fact that lots of Elvis's music was stolen from black artists at the time and modified very little to become his song that he profited off of, while they saw no profits in return. Baz described this movie as a superhero film rather than a biopic, which makes his choice to kind of leave out this accountability make a bit more sense. However, I would have liked to see a bit more. Though we do see a lot of just black people on the screen throughout the movie, and we meet characters like B.B. King and Fats Domino and Mahalia Jackson, they could have had more depth, I think, and I wish that we had seen a bit of the frustration that they had just verbally said to Elvis at a point in the movie. The movie is 2 hours and 40 minutes, so I don't think that, you know, adding a scene where we get just a little bit more on that would have taken away from any other part of the film, but that's just my opinion. I would have liked to see a lot more on that. We do see, right after what I just described as my favorite scene, Elvis is sitting in the club with B.B. King, and they're listening to Little Richard perform Tutti Frutti with his leg up on the piano, and he's dancing around. It's all, people are having the time of their lives, and Elvis leans over to B.B. King and says, "Oh man, what I wish that I could record this song," or something along those lines. And each time I hear it, I've seen it twice now, so this two times I've seen it, my face goes each time, because it is just so known that Elvis was taking music from black people and profiting off of them. Even though we see in this moment that it's out of a place of admiration and love of music, it still is something that I think they could have done more with, and something I would have liked to see a bit more controversy over in terms of how Baz went about approaching that. However, I do appreciate the amount of black people in the movie itself, the choices of who they were speaking about. I think that was really smart, but there just could have been a little bit more, in my opinion. Going from that, I want to talk about Austin Butler. Oh my gosh, this man had such an amazing performance in this movie. I'm 20, I'm a Gen Zer, right? So I've seen Austin Butler in his Nickelodeon Disney Channel days, but man, oh my goodness, I had not seen him in years, and he just comes out of the gate just, oh my goodness, it was amazing. Left me a little bit speechless just because I hadn't seen this man in so long, and he comes out with such an amazing performance. It makes me want to see more of his work and what he's done. And you go to his filmography and you see Sharpay's Fabulous Adventure and Zoe 101. It just doesn't seem like enough for the level of actor that he presents himself to be in this movie. On the other hand, we do have Tom Hanks giving one of his lower performances, I'll say. He was very cartoonish. He almost seemed to know that he was in a Baz Luhrmann film and then just overcompensate for that reason, and it came off very cartoonish, very Disney Channel acting. Even the moments, the second time around, I was focusing on him a little bit more, and there was moments where he's just standing there next to Austin Butler, but you see him acting still with these crazy facial expressions that just were unnecessary, in my opinion, and took away from the moment itself. That being said, Tom Hanks is still an amazing actor, and he doesn't ruin the whole movie for this reason. Again, 2 hours and 40 minutes, you have a lot to work with in that time. But I think it could have been even better if he wasn't doing the level of acting he decided to do that day as Colonel Parker, you know? I don't want to say too much more. I really want people to go see this movie because I think it is so worth seeing. And it is amazing. That being said, I'm giving this a 4 out of 5 stars. Might seem a little bit high, but I am just such a big fan of Baz Luhrmann. He is definitely in my top 3 directors, that anything from him just makes me so excited and so happy, that, you know what? YOLO, you know, YOLO. I loved it, and I hope that you go see it. Even if you don't love it, I hope that it's an experience, you know, that it's still fun, something to go see, you know, something different than every other Marvel movie coming out or every other action movie coming out. So anyway, thanks for tuning in. This is my first video ever. I hope it wasn't horrible. Fingers crossed. Give it a like if you feel so drawn to. Okay, signing out. See you later.